Kenny. Hello and welcome to Global Multimedia Online TV with me, your presenter, Tryfina Elizabeth Coca. And this is Global Multimedia Online TV. On 16 June 1976, the uprising that began in Soweto and spread throughout South Africa changed the country's socio-political landscape. The events were rooted in apartheid policies that resulted in the introduction of the Bantu Education Act in 1953. Many African countries commemorate this day to demonstrate solidarity of the deadly incident. Many organizations in Sierra Leone contributed in their own different ways to help strengthen the minds and ambition of children. Help the Young to Grow organization has chipped in to support children in Makeni in that direction. Handela Mac-Williams put this together and now reports.
On the 16th of June every year, the Day of the African Child is celebrated all around Africa in commemoration of the Soweto Uprising on June 16, 1976, where thousands of students were killed and ambushed. Since 1991, the Day of the African Child has been celebrated to remember those killed during this unforgettable time and to recognize the courage of students who march for their rights to education. Africa pays tribute to the lives of these students and acknowledge the roles of youth in Africa. June 16 marks the commemoration of National Day Youth in South Africa and West Africa as a whole. Help the Young to Grow is a charitable organization that assists vulnerable children who are going to school and also drop out in communities. Global Multimedia Online TV was there with Help the Young to Grow and other organizations to join the children and youth to celebrate this day. We talk with Jibrila Abbas Wisdom Kamara, Country Coordinator of Help the Young to Grow.
A charity and non-profitable organization that really deals with young people, children. And today is their day. It's the International Day for the African Child. We commemorate the day and also we celebrate the day. You know, we organize a day every year, we organize a program every year wherein we call upon other organizations to join us, commemorate or celebrate the day. And this year, 2020, in the midst of COVID-19, it's not an exception. We really like want to do it in another colorful way, even in the midst of this virus that is killing people here and there. So we call on other organizations and have some, advice from health practitioners that we can carry on with the program, but in cognizance of the rules and regulations of the COVID-19.
Mr. John Banato Sisse, representative from the EOC, speak to us on this interview.
We tell the children that are not around here or somewhere else is that they should observe all the medical advices for COVID-19. One, they should wash their hands regularly with clean water and soap. Two, they should wear masks as I do. And the third one, they should observe distance.
Paulina Adamari Sisse, a pupil of the St. Joseph Secondary School, was one of the participants for the program, and this was what she had to say.
Well, the meaning of this day is that we remember the day when BC will come to the kingdom, the fight for their freedom.
As part of the mandate of Help the Young to Grow, helping children is key to them, and children activities is at the heart of their operations. Global Multimedia Online TV Daily Room News, Andela Mac-Williams reporting.
The reinstated Resident Minister North has returned in his region 1 week after his reinstatement. While speaking to Global Multimedia Online TV, Honorable Abu Abdullahi Kouma said his period on suspension taught him several lessons that he will use to build more bridges this time round. I was part of this symbolic welcoming. The reinstated Resident Minister North has made his first official visit in the region. Honorable Abu Abdullahi Kouma, who was reinstated last week by his boss, retired Brigadier Julius Mada Bio, the President of the Republic of Sierra Leone, was welcomed by hundreds of supporters, well-wishers, party stewards and sympathizers in the northern city of Makeni. In an exclusive interview with the minister, Mr. Kouma said that his suspension period taught him several lessons. With these lessons learnt, the Honorable Minister says he would implement such lessons to build more bridges rather than fences.
A lot. One of the things that I learned was we should always accept our mistakes. Even if you are a leader, you should do accept your own mistakes because you are a human being. You are liable to mistakes and you should be accepted to correct those mistakes. So I learned a lot. One of it is when you are in trouble, it will help you to identify those that loves you more. It will help you to identify your challenges.
Though the reinstated resident minister made a public apology immediately when his utterances went viral, he also made the same apology to people in the north and the country upon his return.
I can also say sorry today because now that I've been reinstated, I'm very much pleased for them to accept me back. Those that are sending abusive languages against me on social media, let them withdraw because we are all Sierra Leoneans, we are all human beings.
In another development, Soma Community Christian Primary School is a fully funded operational school under the full supervision of the Bridge of Hope charity organization, Regional Office North, Makeni. The organization has donated 337 bags of rice, 25 kg, to 337 less privileged children attending this school. These children are coming from deprived villages around the environment of Bombali District. Included are Makambo, Makama, Pet Banamasimbo, and many more. A project worth $4,814, equivalent to 47,180,000 in leones. And this, according to the organization, is to help remedy the negative poses by the deadly coronavirus. Idris Ajeri was part of this donation process and files in this report.
COVID-19 pandemic has affected the smooth running of all operations in the world. As a result of this, many countries have decided to close schools, colleges, and universities. The severe short-term disruption is felt by many families around the world. Homeschooling is not just a massive shock to parents' productivity, but also to child's social life and learning. Importantly, these interruptions will not just be a short-term issue, but can also have long-term consequences for the affected cohort, are likely to increase child labor, teenage pregnancy, school dropout, to name but few. To reduce this existing enemy on our children and future leaders, Bridge of Hope has chipped in this direction. By donating 337 bags of 25 kg rice to 37 deprived children coming from deprived households in vulnerable communities in Bombali District. Amadou Mohamed Kouroma is the Child Advocate and Assistant Education Superintendent Officer, Bridge of Hope. He speaks on the rationale of this project.
Presently, we are embarking on rice distribution to school vulnerable pupils in our operational areas. And we thought it fit of providing this support because we have been providing school feeding program before this time, starting the inception of our schools in 2006. Also free medical as well as also free education. So when COVID-19 entered in Sierra Leone on the 31st of March, they decided to close school. Then I thought it as a child advocate that we have some pupils that have used to survive through our school feeding program, and especially the vulnerable. So in this case, we need also to supplement this feeding program in the absence of their going to school. Well, basically my expectation to them, because looking at the Bridge of Hope, one of our vision is to see that we envisage Sierra Leone as a place wherein we can able to fight poverty, we can able to provide the basic needs of the people, and education is not an exception.
Further advise and encourage children and parents.
To start with the pupils, I will start to encourage them to hold tight to their books, because education is the only asset that we can able to offer to them. They are the people that have to rescue you in your old age. They are the people that have to help you most of your needs that you're not able to have as of this time. So the same thing also, I'm encouraging them. That's why you see we have so many prizes that we are giving them just to motivate.
Beneficiaries expressed their impression on this gesture.
Then the summer until now, I was be happy because at long time we need to collect our food, but now when the school was closed, I was so very hungry, because sometimes I don't have the feeding when my parents can feed me. But as for now, I thank God, because I know one day government can be open the school. As for today, I feel many great happy, because I cannot sit when I was seeing the rice. But now when the rice was there at home, I cannot walk because I love to eat. I love to eat.
So
I feel very unhappy. Because to have a book at the for study. Because when I stop cooking, I don't get a chance to study again.
I don't feel fine. I really feel bad. It make me another story. I'm happy. And I tell her thank you. I also tell the bridge thank you for that matter.
Global Multimedia Online TV Daily Room News, I am Idrissa Jerry.
A strong, staunch, and energetic father, brother, friend, and journalist journeyed to his ancestors on the 13th of June 2020. Families, friends, and students of the University of Makeni solemnly regret the death of their beloved late Abdul Charles Mansale, a former lecturer at the University of Makeni and of the Mass Communications Department, and a former worker at Radio Maria Makeni. His burial ceremony attracts key stakeholders, among whom the Bishop of Makeni Diocese and Chancellor of University of Makeni, Natalio Paganelli, Vice Chancellor UNIMAC, Reverend Father Joseph Almami Toure, staffs of UNIMAC, staffs of Radio Maria, SLAGE North President Sir James Banga, students of the Mass Communications Department, and many more dignitaries. Let's take a look of this ceremony.
Are they part of this family now, of the late Abdul Charles Mansale? I come up for Noam 2004, where Radio Maria be start, na Basua Center, na Makeni. We try to level best, Nkanaya, at this building, Musa Utinap today, Musa Dele, my brother Naya, and Abdul Charles Mansale. We don't know somebody.
Well, on behalf of the Diocese of Makeni, where the university and the radio, and the Diocese of Makeni get up, we want to say we heartfelt condolence and sympathy to the whole family, the family. And Charles, now somebody we not afraid for take any initiative. 2003, we want to start the radio. He announced that the turn, we look at the diocese. Abdul Mansale, he decide for join me. So Abdul Mansale, now the founding father of Radio Maria, among the very first, the Radio Maria. Abdul Charles Mansale continue for work with Radio Maria. As a journalist, now possibly we're not afraid. We come from South Africa, we send him to South Africa, we go to Mandela, and Robin Island, we decide to put Mandela. for how many years we can be more emboldened for TINAP for the poor, for TINAP for the vulnerable. So journalists not afraid for talk with me, right?
The student and the agree for similar and carry them.
Well, Albert Charles can be described from various angles. Some people know him as a lecturer, some know him as brother, some know him as friend, some know him as journalist. As for me, I know him from those angles. He was like a friend and brother, was also a colleague. Indeed, he had a life that is worth emulating, and I think he contributed greatly to nurturing the upcoming journalists, the next generation of journalists from this part of the country. He contributed to bringing them up through his professionalism, and later he joined academia at the University of McKinney, where he taught, and many of the oncoming journalists passed through his hands. So in that way, he has helped to build the next generation.
Partnership in the fight against COVID-19 is needed, and all sectors should be treated with open platform. The Ministry of Social Welfare, Gender and Children Affairs, with other partners, has distributed assorted items to some quarantine homes, safe homes, and orphanage homes. This is in line with commemorating the Day of the African Child. Our reporter Hassan Jallo has more.
The Day of the African Child, June 16, is a day that children use to celebrate and commemorate what's happening with their colleagues in Soweto, South Africa, when many children were killed for their right to education. Many African countries used to celebrate this day, of which Sierra Leone is not an exemption. On this day, the Ministry of Social Welfare, Gender and Children Affairs with their partners used to organize different programs for children in order to see their happiness in society. But during this era of the global pandemic, COVID-19, the ministry and its partners decided to give out assorted materials like Veronica buckets, soaps, sanitary pads, and many more to children in quarantine homes, safe homes, and orphanages, in order to make them feel lively in society and observe precautionary measures in fighting against the global pandemic. The ministry and its partner also preach motivational words to the children that all is not lost and they are always with them, because they are the future leaders of this nation.
Adeya. And because una dey allow una not fit say, oh, social welfare not there with you again, oh, because of this sickness. We really deal with una social welfare and the partners there. So now make we come and can talk to una. Yeah? Una very much important. Let una stay safe. Let una stay blessed. Yeah? And let una do what in mama and the teacher there where they are. They tell una. Yeah?
The ministry and its partners also mentioned, if not for the pandemic, they should have organized many programs for the children to learn and feel happy in society.
Normally, we used to have representatives from here, not so. And then you go to the hall, and then we have this day commemorated and celebrated. But because of the COVID-19, we cannot have all of you there. Yeah, so that's why we come, so that we'll see how you're doing. You know, we talk, we play, and then, I mean, all of us will feel happy for this day.
Reporting for Global Multimedia Online TV Daily Room News, I am Hassan Jallo.
And in sports, ban was made into effect at a time when the country's headway in the development in sporting activities, with special reference to football, is extremely visible and completely unarguable. At the mid of the Sierra Leone Premier League and other local leagues across the provinces, the uninvited and unexpected visitor struck into the nation, which precipitated the indefinite ban on the sporting activities. Let's join our sports correspondent Desmond A.J. Farmer. He investigated the effect it has poses on few players.
Following the unprecedented high spread rate of coronavirus COVID-19 across the world, which has affected almost every country directly or indirectly, the Ministry of Sports on the 17th May 2020, as part of its numerous preventive measures, put on hold in all sporting activities until further notice. In Makeni, the headquarter town of Bombale District, players who have taken the football career as a profession are indirectly affected by the COVID-19 and the indefinite ban on sports activities. Players expressed their views on how they have been affected by the ban, which is due to the high rate of the spread of the virus, and social distancing being one of the pillars to curb the spread. Abash JCC is a passionate footballer who plays for the Saino Football Club, and he expressed his views on this interview.
So much for this weekend, going to the strike now. First of all, we go by our first for our corner, we will play here, next to my first piece there, on Sunday.
I went ahead paying an unannounced visit to Issa A. Tarawali, normally known as Apex. Apex is a household name in Makeni and Bombale districts, largely known for his outstanding inputs and performance in the football career. And these were his views.
Unfortunate because of right now, football not to take place. So right now, we play, they're not to feel happy because one guy win, they make right now, they lost some good training. Yeah, because right now, nobody knows for training. So we need big for our government, so they put the lips back now, upload the gift back, all the good things, they're ready to cancel back.
Molai Konte, who many people know as Keule, playing for Teddy FC, in this interview expressed his dissatisfaction as his activities as professional footballer has been put on hold.
We don't go there. Only they play football, we don't go there. Most of we don't plan some things that we do say for push for good football, all along the game, and we should not make all things along the game.
He, however, made a general advice to colleague players to be involved in daily workouts and basic trainings to keep them fit with pace after COVID-19. The Sierra Leone Football Association, in a press release, however, announced that the Sierra Leone Premier League and other local leagues across the provinces will be completed as soon as the COVID-19 is declared eradicated. Reporting for Global Multimedia Online TV Daily Room News, I am Desmond Alfie Jonathan Fama.
This is all what we have time for in today's Global Multimedia Online TV flagship program Daily Room News. I have been your presenter, Trifina Elizabeth Coker. Have a pleasant night. Cheers.
Dr. Vincent Cano Road in Makeni.